Hey, I just left Cedro Woolley, which is about 60, 30, 45 miles out of Bellingham, and I'm in a little town called Marblemount. It's got about 280 people populating it, and I like it so far. It's pretty awesome. I just came into the Alpine RV Park, and I've set my tent up. I actually think you can see my tent if I come over to this window. Oh, there are lots of spiders, so I'm going to stand far away. But yeah, there's my tent and stuff all set up. I showered, which was awesome. I haven't showered, well, I can't say that anymore. Previously, like 4 hours ago, if I was doing this, I would have not had showered for like 3 days. I was miserable. But I came here, and they're like, if you're camping, showers are free. And I'm like, yes! That's pretty much what I said. And I ran and got all the clean in and all the not clean out. Now I'm doing laundry, because I also was out of laundry. There's my stack of underwear. Sorry. but yeah, I've been thinking about it, and I'm a pretty decent, decent way into my trip now, and I'm kind of starting to find my America. It's pretty awesome. The one thing that I've noticed about Washington is there aren't like Walmarts or Cars Safeways or like Cost Savers. Everything's locally owned and kind of like family owned. It's really cool because every town just has this like weird, awesome character about it, which is awesome. Lots of farms. Yeah, it's just a bunch of people who decide, hey, I think I want to have a sandwich shop. And then they, you know, get a farm, have some cows, make their own cheese, and then, you know, hey, try my sandwich. It's got Washington cheese, Washington cow cheese. And then you're like, whoa, I want that sandwich now because it's original and it's so rich. And once I have that sandwich, I can say, hey, have you had that sandwich from Washington? Well, which sandwich do you mean? The one with Washington cow cheese. And then people are like, oh my goodness, I have to go there. It's just cool. It's really cool. But yeah, the trip's going well so far. I took a few wrong turns, but I didn't turn back. And so I just went off in one direction for like 40 miles, and then decided, you know what, I think I'm lost enough. I'm going to go back to my starting point and just consider this a warm-up. And so that's what I've done. But today was a lot better. I actually didn't take the right route today either, but it got me to my destination. But it's fun. Just looking out for all those special little moments that make the trip worth it. All right, yeah, I'm about to go. Oh, okay, this is what I wanted to talk about in the blog, but then I got sidetracked by the spiders and the tent and my clothing and then the hair and everything. Tomorrow, I'm actually starting my ascent. I don't know if that's a word. Yeah, ascent's a word. Maybe. I don't know. Gosh, I'm going to use it anyways. The opposite of descent. I'm going to start climbing into the Cascades. Tomorrow's about an 80-mile day, and I'm going to start pretty early. I think I want to leave by like 7 o'clock. And yeah, I'm going from an altitude of 200 feet, which is what I'm at right now, and hopefully, well, by the end of my climb, I will be at 5,400 some odd feet. So, I'm looking forward to that. I think it'll be fun. I just got to remember to bring lots of water and pray that it won't be scorching hot, because that will be miserable. But yeah, this was a long video blog, but I just wanted to catch everybody up. The America that I've found so far is fantastic. I love it. Lots of farms, lots of horses, and lots of really awesome looking places. I'm going to finish folding my laundry, and then I'm going to go to bed and probably upload this. I'm John, and this is my America.